I was recently watching a shoot interview involving D'Lo Brown. He was describing his time in Smoky Mountain, in which in a match he was in, including you, I can't tell whose hand slipped here. I guess it was yours. Had slipped his hand while holding your bloody head, and shoot punched you in the face. There we go. Just wanted to know if there was any more memories about Mr. Brown and any mistakes like this one.
Oh, D'Lo potatoed the fuck out of me. A number of times. I remember one time in Morristown, it was me and Boo Bradley, who later became Balls Mahoney, against D'Lo Brown and Killer Kyle. And D'Lo came, they're getting heat on me. We're the baby faces, right? in this fucking alternate universe. And D'Lo was going to come off the top of the clothesline, but I came up to my feet a little too close to the fucking corner, and D'Lo came off the top and just knocked the fuck out of me. I had started D'Lo in the business. Well, I didn't start him in the business. He had been wrestling in the New Jersey area. And Chris Candido said, "Hey, I got this friend from Jersey, and he looks just like Ernie Ladd." I said, "Oh my God." And he said, "You know, he's going to come down to Tennessee. Can you use him?" "Of course. If he looks just like Ernie Ladd, yes, Jesus Christ, H. Yeah. Yeah. He's booked already." Right. Well, we get to the TV that night, and D'Lo is, instead of 6'9", 325, he's 6 feet tall and about 300 pounds at that point, maybe a little more. And I said, "You look nothing like fucking Ernie Ladd, but I want to see how you work." And he was a great worker. He was a natural. He was a guy you could tell he's going to be great, right? Hmm. And so I told him after that, I said, "Look, I can't offer you much money, but if you want to," he was a CPA, certified public accountant in New Jersey, and had a good job and making money. Huh. I said, "If you want to be in the wrestling business, I can't offer you very much money, but I will book you." And that's when I brought the gangsters in, New Jack and Mustafa. And New Jack could talk his ass off, and Mustafa looked great, but neither one of them could work worth a shit. And I said, they need a regular posse member, and it would help that you can work so you can fucking be the fall guy for them. And, you know, you can have a job on the ring crew and blah, blah, blah. "So I can't offer you much money, but if you want to be in the wrestling business, you come down here, I'll book you."
And so a certified public accountant and New Jack.
Yes, exactly. And they had their problems, and they had some hotel room fucking scuffles and et cetera, et cetera. We won't get into right now. But anyway, D'Lo came down, and, you know, his name is A.C. Connor. And I said, what do you want your wrestling name to be?" And he said, "How about Downtown D'Lo Brown?" I said, "Okay, book it. You're done." Yeah, that's good. And he was the guy in the gangsters that Mustafa wasn't the worker, and New Jack wasn't the worker, but he was the talker. Mustafa looked great, but D'Lo was the guy who would drop the falls and you could work with. And he also became part of my ring crew. And the guy that had the ring trailer and owned the truck that hauled it was named Harold Varner. And if he wasn't a legitimate card-carrying member of the Ku Klux Klan, he missed a hell of a chance. Oh, Jesus. He was an old fucking redneck, racist motherfucker. And so I paired D'Lo Brown, a black man, certified public accountant, college-educated motherfucker from New Jersey, with a goddamn racist KKK member from fucking East Tennessee, and they were the ring crew. And one night, I get back from a show in Johnson City, and my phone rings, and it's midnight, and it's D'Lo. And he says, "God damn it, that fucking Harold Varner, I fucking fed up with his shit. He fucking said nigger this and nigger that, and I told him to go fuck himself, and he put me out of the goddamn car." D'Lo was walking down the side of Interstate 81 with his bag and his fucking early cell phone, or I guess he'd stopped at a gas station or however he called me, and he was stranded, and I sent somebody, I don't know whether it was Brian Hildebrand, but who it was, to go get him. But he lasted through that, and I give him all the credit in the world. He didn't make a lot of money, and he had to put up with Harold Varner shit. But that was where he got his wrestling education. And then when it came time that I went to work for Vince in Stamford, I got the Headbangers jobs and I got D'Lo Brown a job. And I signed papers. I'd given the Headbangers their name and I'd allegedly given D'Lo Brown his name. And I signed papers. Yes, they're all yours. Just hire them. And that's how D'Lo got his spot up north. And he's one of my favorite people. He's a hell of a guy. He was a tremendous talent. He still is. I worked with him in TNA. I can't say enough good about D'Lo Brown and all the shit that he went through to get in the wrestling business, but and having to put up with New Jack and his bullshit. But D'Lo Brown is, he had a fucking hard row to hoe, as they say down south, to get in the wrestling business, but he persevered and he's a tremendous worker to this day. And I would trust him more than I would trust most people with my life or property, because D'Lo is a hell of a guy.